ladies and gentlemen of all ages, boys and girls. Thank you for tuning in to yet another episode of Angry Meat Production. We appreciate you coming in and letting us be a part of your lives, week in and week out. We hope to do our best to present you with something that your eardrums delight in. Whether you're looking at us on YouTube or Rumble, or listening to us on Spotify, Google, or Anchor, or any of the other podcast services that we are currently on or trying to get on, we thank you. And if you don't mind, at the end of every episode, stop by, leave us a comment, leave us a like. If it asks for 5 stars, we'll take 5 stars, even if you don't like us. 5 stars are what it's all about. With that being said, we hope you enjoy our attempt to make our advocation our vocation. Ladies and gentlemen, let the games begin. We here at Angry Meat Production want to thank our sponsor, Mobile Notary Mindy. She's certified with the National Notary Association. She's also bonded and E&O insured. She offers a wide range of services, including wills, powers of attorney, medical documents, healthcare proxies, living wills, certification of trust, assignment of personal property, HIPAA waivers, advanced healthcare directives, and 99 verification. You can find her on Facebook, TikTok, and Instagram at Mobile Notary Mindy. You can also visit her webpage at TexasMobileNotaryMindy.com. That's TXMobileNotaryMindy.com. Thank you so much and enjoy the show.
Welcome, Angry Faithful, to Nerd Sports, episode 164. And today we are without Johnny. We are with our like baby boy, Chris. Chris Jacka's not here. Chris Jacka, he's sick. Hope you're feeling better, brother. Hope you're feeling breath. Anyways, today I'm gonna go old school, and I'm gonna start talking about a really cool sport that I found yesterday, and we're gonna talk about it today. And that is, let's get this going. Mexican dun, poker. Dun, dun, dun. This is hilarious. I watched this yesterday, and watch this. This is Mexican poker. Oh. But now, the idea of Mexican poker, and it's the whole idea of Mexican poker is you're sitting in your seat in a rodeo, and if you're just listening to us, you're not viewing us, this is how the video goes. You have four guys at a plastic table. We'll just say table. They release a bull, and the last one sitting is the guy that wins the poker tournament. And it's not, we're not even calling it a poker tournament. It's just a little poker thing. I saw that video. We watched it yesterday on what the hell, watching talking to my barber, which it was an interesting conversation. It was a lovely conversation with him. And he's like, yeah, and because he did rodeos, and he goes up, he's like, have you ever heard of Mexican poker? I was like, I didn't know what the name of it was. I've heard about it, but I never like, you know, totally heard of actual Mexican poker. And I watched
it's like the donkey show in Tijuana. Yeah, everybody's heard of it until you actually go to TJ and see it. You're like, oh my god, I'll never be the same again. Thank you.
We're not talking about that because we're trying to get more.
Oh, different subscribers. Different sport.
No. More subscribers, because I know what you're talking about, because someone conned me into going to one, and I was like, you don't.
You never get it out of your head.
What's really surprising is after the fact, is she goes around and asks if you want to participate with her afterwards. And I'm like, no.
Tempting.
I am not doing that. Anyways, let me pull up, because we got some baseball news from Houston Astros, both good and bad. I don't know if you heard of it, but there's a new player they pulled off of, I guess, the minor leagues. And hopefully I can find it without all the stuff that's been going on with the Houston Astros this weekend, which was, it was the stupidest thing you could possibly think of. And we'll get into that later on. New player. Let's see here. No. Yeah, it's not coming up. I really need to start sending these to myself, but I deeply apologize about that one. Hopefully Johnny can comment on the thing next week. But the big thing that happened was with Tina Tate. Reason why we're saying this is because it's stupid ridiculous. And we're going to go off of her. I got this from her Twitter account or X account. And it is ridiculous. Let me get this into full view. Okay, everybody, looking at full view on YouTube. We are silent and our rights are being taken away from us. Wake up, America. It's happening everywhere. Today, I walked into the Minute Maid Park wearing all my Astro gears and my free Trump t-shirt. Ticket taker pulled me aside, made me go through an existential metal detector scan, not just the normal one, processed for no apparent reason. I did not have a purse or slash clear bag, just my phone and credit card. Something my daughter had. The only difference between the two of us was I was wearing a shirt that said Free Donald Trump. They quickly phoned another person telling them about my shirt and the seat I was in to keep an eye on me. They threatened to kick me out if I didn't change the cover up my shirt. Luckily, I brought a jacket, which in this Texas heat, that's I'm surprised she brought a jacket. It's 100 degrees out there right now. And it's been that way for the past couple of days. And they threatened to kick me out. I was forced to put on a jacket. Not only is this a violation of my First Amendment rights as a American citizen, it is also very embarrassing. Clothing is protected under the Constitution. I love my Astros and spend tons of money at the tickets booth and Astro gears, but unfortunately, this may be the last game I see in person. Let's fix the problem, America. Do better, Minute Maid. Now, on this, we hear people that believe in the Constitution on this show. Johnny was saying beforehand when we were commenting about is going to be absent this day because he's going on vacation. But we both he went on the niceness about it. Let's just say that he was like, well, Houston's kind of a liberal town, and big cities are. No matter what, big cities are usually more on the liberal side of things, except for like Fort Worth. Fort Worth is big and it's very red.
But see, there we go again. But if we do it like that, and if we give that excuse, like, oh, it's a big city, it's okay, it's going to happen there because they're more liberal, so obviously it's going to be accepted to where they're not going to allow you the rights that you have as an American citizen. No, I mean, I understand exactly what you're saying, but that's the way that it's coming off and the way it's coming out across to everybody, because it's not just limited to one place. Don't tell me what I can and I cannot wear. especially if I'm paying you to go see a game, which is costing an infinitely more, exponentially more expensive than it should be, for one. And then you want to bitch about what I'm wearing? Fuck off.
Yeah, and she has most photos and everything of her wearing the shirt with her kids and everything. Let me pull this stuff up. I mean, she's in the public eye right now, so
that's good.
But that's her free Trump t-shirt, her and her kids. And it's understanding to the point of, hey, you're going to someone else's company. And yes, you might have paid for, I mean, I'm not going to wear Klan stuff and everything or something that's very vile and offensive to other places. But that's not vile. That's a little bit political. But nowadays, it's hurtful to be political. Oh, you're going to. And I bet where she was sitting, she was visible to the cameras. That's my only because, like I said, in the what she said on it was they looked at her seat. So she was probably behind the bullpen. She was probably behind the home plate or something to that extent. And that's the reason why they was like, no, we can't have her there. We can't have her in front of a camera. We can't have her doing that. But it's the company stuff. And a lot of people are probably going to get, baseball isn't as popular as it used to be. So they're not filling that many seats that much. So why are you kicking people out because they're wearing a shirt? That now, if it said something to the fact of, something,
kill white people,
to the extent, something like really, really, really,
But then again, she could wear that shirt if she wants to, because A, whether or not it's appropriate makes no difference. If that's what she wants to wear, she could wear it. It's just a shirt with words on it. That's all it comes down to. And if we make it any more than just a shirt with words, then it has some kind of power and it has some kind of control. And at that point, we're now just talking about a fucking shirt.
Yeah. I mean,
a shirt ruined her day, basically, for no good reason.
Yeah, it's really ridiculous that we're on a sports show talking about a shirt that was in a ball game. Now we have shirts that go out the beforehand. It's like first part of Joe Biden's administration. Let's go Brandon. That was popular for a while.
It's the only bumper sticker I've ever seen for Joe Biden. It's the only one out there.
Yeah, but it's like I said, it's really ridiculous that we're talking about a shirt. I mean, let's get off that topic. See if there's any kind of baseball news. I was set everything for everything else, the talking points that I want to talk about today, but I didn't fully get all of them. Let's see here. Because there's not really any kind of NFL news. We got hockey.
Darren Waller retired from the NFL after his divorce from WNBA star Casey Plum. So,
go ahead and talk about that.
Darren Waller was originally a Raider, drafted by the Raiders. He then got traded to the Giants, where at some point in time he developed a relationship with Casey Plum. Casey Plum is a WNBA player, a star, if you will. They got married, kind of one of those whirlwind romances, you know, those always work out with no problems. Especially with two people that are famous with wealth, what could go wrong? Everything. So, unfortunately for Mr. Waller, or fortunately for Mr. Waller, he gets to have two bachelor parties. So, I think after he gets his head together and realizes that he's too young to retire from football, he'll probably decide to come back. But for right now, he has officially retired from the New York Football Giants. And that is as of today.
I can't believe this is okay. This is June 4th that this came out. Shohei Ohtani's former interpreter, Mishihara, admitted his guilt of stealing nearly $17 million from the Dodgers superstar to pay gambling debts. Major League Baseball also announced disciplinary actions against several other players, including San Diego Padres infielder Tupacata Marcano for gambling violations. I guess they're hitting hard with a lot. I didn't know there was like more of gambling violations for the last couple of years, which is... I understand where baseball is coming from. I mean, they have it's too easily going to fix the game in their favor if they're having gambling violations and everything.
But check this out. Prior to, let's say, the last couple years, prior to the pandemic, let's go before that. Do you ever remember like DraftKings and Underdog Fantasy and Prize Picks and all these other ESPN bet? FanDuel, I can name 100 different ones, and everybody's getting involved in it. And when it comes to gambling and it comes to money, you're gonna have people put their own personal interest ahead of others, whether it be Jonte Porter, who played for the Raptors and got caught gambling on games and actually affecting potentially the outcome of games by not playing and or playing poorly, is now out of the league. So when you entice people to gamble and you push it every commercial break, during podcasts, during people's live streams, that is somehow going to get embedded and they're going to want to take a part of it to see whether or not, you know, temptation is a very easy thing to overlook and become addicted to, just like anything else.
No, you're absolutely right. But the only problem with it is it's up to those people. I mean, these are grown adults.
You would think.
You have a choice. You have a choice of, okay, they said they can still gamble. They're grown adults. They can still gamble. But they can't gamble on the sport they're playing with. That's like me going up and buying like a shit ton of Rolls-Royce stocks. And I'm working for a company that makes those blades that go onto that airplane. I find out about it through my company that they're making a big plane and we're going to be making and selling a crap load of Rolls-Royce blades to fit these planes, and there's going to be like 70 planes. That's a lot of money. I mean, maybe probably not 70, probably around about, you know, 4 to 5, and the government's buying it, so we're getting that government money for these blades and we're going to make a lot of money off that. Well, I start buying Rolls Royce stuff. That's insider training. If I wasn't like super rich, I would probably be in jail if I did it.
Sure.
That's the same thing. Now, insider trading is kind of like a loopy thing, especially if I was like a rich man or if I was a congressman, they wouldn't touch me. No. We all know this. But it's that realm of thinking that you have to understand. That's the reason why they can't do it. Because that's like I just said. And the whole reason why is back in the day, the mafia fixed the games. They would fix college bowls. They would fix horse races. I mean, it's known. We all know this. One of the players had too much debt. Well, guess what? I'm going to put a lot of money on the other team this week. You're going to have to fix that. Okay. I guess I'll fix the game. And then they lose, and they lose the championship they were about to get. All because someone goes in and decides, hey, today's not today, boys. We're not winning today. Back it off a little bit. But that's the whole reason why they have that. And so you can't fix the game. It's understandable because, you know, people are paying for this. It's you got a lot of money going into these things, and you just can't fix it to where, oh, it's going to be unexciting. Nobody's going to watch it anymore because, oh, the outcome is Frankie Two Toes just bet on the other team. So I think they're going to win. No, they're not. They win. Well, surprise, surprise. It's no fun after that. Why would you fix games? Because, okay, the thing about fixing games is if you already know the outcome, why are you watching it? It's reading at the end of the book. Why do you even want to even try? I mean, this year in the Super Bowl, the underdog, everybody was going for the Ravens. No one was going for Kansas City. People were going for Kansas City, but, you know, they both didn't like Kansas City Chiefs, and nobody really wanted to watch the 49ers. Everybody was agreeing on that. They didn't want to see either one of those teams win. But guess what? We still watched the Super Bowl. Why? We wanted to see which team we hated the most wins.
And just for...
Don't you even say it. Don't you even say it, Max. Just because you're in Kansas City doesn't mean you get to give us your bullshit.
It's not even that. Everybody associates the Chiefs now with 14-year-old Taylor Swift fans, so I don't know how much glory there is about that.
Okay, so. You're a writer. Here's the thing. I've been catching up on Jason Kelce and Travis Kelce, their podcast. It's a good podcast. It's good.
It's awesome.
Good. Yeah, it really is. It's a really good podcast. And Travis is saving me, saying it's one of those things that he cares about Travis and Taylor Swift, but he's never been in that kind of spotlight. I mean, even as a football player, he's in kind of spotlight. But if he goes into a different city, not many people are going to know him. They're not going to stop him. They're not going to, you know. I wouldn't know anything about Travis Kelce unless, you know, he popped up and he's like, hey, how's it going? I'm like, hey, how's it going? I wouldn't know who he was. And I'm not a football fan or anything like that. We'd probably have a good conversation or anything. We'd bye, you know, high five. Cool guy. All right. But now he's associated with a person that's super in the spotlight. He doesn't know how to handle it. He's literally said this a couple of times. He's like, this is so weird, and I'm going to work through this with her, but it's a really weird experience for me because I've never been like that type of spotlight. I've been in a spotlight. I know how to take care of myself and into that thing, but I'm in a different level now, and it's kind of scary.
Right.
And it is kind of scary. I mean, our basic instincts as humans isn't to be noticed. If you are noticed, it's only trying to get a woman and you're trying to peacock her. But in all reality, the whole thing is try to be inconsistent, unnoticeable, and just survive. Don't get eaten by that lion that's probably hiding in those bushes. There's a lion hiding in the bushes in Texas. I'm not going to be surprised. More of a tiger. We have a lot of tigers here in Texas.
there, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, Texas is number one in exotic animal ownership.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's fucking awesome.
Dude, we have...
I want a pterodactyl. If you see an extra one for sale, send me the link and I'm going to buy it.
I'll end up giving you the pterodactyl. But it's...
You're just saying that.
They're trying to do Jurassic Park. It's stupid, ridiculous. They're actually trying to do Jurassic Park, and it's...
Oh, you're being serious.
Yes, they are. There's so many stuff that's going on in genetic scale on cloning and everything. Because we don't hear a lot of cloning stories in the United States because Bill Clinton in his massive intelligence and someone in his administration is, we don't want cloning. I just watched Jurassic Park, probably. That's the reason why we don't want cloning. I hate to say it, but United States watches movies and they think everything's real in them. But in other countries, cloning's open-minded about it. They do a lot of genetic research. China right now, I believe, is heading up on a lot of the genetic research, which is scary that they're doing that.
That's our buddies, Joe Biden.
Yeah, yeah. But
when do they, Dolly the Sheep? When do they clone Dolly the Sheep? That's been 30 years ago. They've been
cloning dogs since the 70s.
Fucking the Russians took the head off a dog and put it on another dog, and that motherfucker lived.
I'm looking up, when did they do Dolly Sheep? Dolly Sheep. That was 96. Was the first 96. Female fine Doris sheep and first mammal that was cloned from an adult Semic cell. And she lived for 7 years. What's the lifespan of a sheep?
Sounds like a pretty good, I mean, you know, what's the lifespan of a dog? You know, 7 years for a dog is like, you know, what, 49 years for a human?
10 to 12 years. So she had a good life. So it's not that, a little bit early, but you know, sheep usually go for 10 to 12 years. So 7 years is not even a bad, she lived for quite a while. So
yeah, and she was like a normal sheep.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It wasn't like the sheep went crazy and decided to fucking crazy sheep and developed fucking satanic horns and started, you know, fucking other sheep.
Like in sheep, what is it? Sheep experiment or sheep? Johnny plays it all the time. He keeps on talking about it. But they have a thing where you turn into a demonic sheep.
Oh. Demonic sheep, when we say that, we're not talking about the Democrats and liberals. We're talking about an actual movie.
Yeah.
A production.
Yeah. But going
our on... Our left-leaning audience.
Yes. If we have them. But NBA news. Boston is, I think, 2-0. I think they're... NBA Finals.
Yeah, they won last night. It was a pretty good game, much better than the game prior. It was a lot closer. Dallas was a lot more competitive. They showed up. They were ready to play. However, Boston is just too much, in my opinion, for Dallas. And if Boston ends up winning one of those games in Dallas, I would say the series is more than likely going to be over.
Do you think Celtics are going to take it in game four? Because they, so far, all they have to do is win two more games.
Yeah. Like I said, they're halfway there versus, you know, the Mavericks who are trying to find their play still, make the matchups that work best. They've been getting beat down low inside the post, Porzingis has been a real troublemaker for them. They haven't had any real good matchups, whether it be Gafford or Lively the second on Dallas to try to match up with them. And when you've got Tatum, who hasn't necessarily been dynamic by any means, but he's contributed enough to get them and keep them in the game and allow them to win. The standout star so far in the series, in my opinion, other than Jaylen Brown, has been Derek White. And I expect the Celtics to probably split the series when they go to Dallas. And I believe that game is going to be tomorrow because the Panthers are playing tonight against the Oilers.
Yeah.
So
actually,
they're playing right now, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And in my opinion, I think that Dallas has a good team. I think they've got a good squad. I think they're still young. But ultimately, I think this is Boston's year. And there's not a whole lot that, you know, destiny's destiny, right?
Yeah. Speaking on NHL news, game one was already done. Panthers 3, Oilers 0. So the Florida Panthers came in a lead, which they didn't. I think what had happened with this game with the Oilers and the Panthers is Oilers didn't have their secret weapon. And if you've been keeping up with the news, Oilers do have a secret weapon that they ended up winning and getting into the finals. And it's a hell of a weapon. They're D cups. I mean, that woman helped out the Oilers in such a way by showing her chest that the Oilers won. I mean, the other team was just confused and what was happening and everything. It was the best secret weapon you could possibly pull out.
It was such honestly, a good secret weapon that I'm going to add it to the show on the Rumble area. That way nobody gets offended by breasts, which women possess.
Yes. But it was
beautiful.
It was a beautiful secret weapon. I'm so happy about them. We didn't get her name or anything. She's just a nameless.
She's beautiful.
I know.
And she took pride in like, that.
My team's losing. They're winning. Yay! Diddies! That's what happened. I mean, everybody's going off as like the players had skill and everything. No. It wasn't that. It was not that. It was, in definition, that young, nameless woman. I say young. She was fully grown adult. Woman.
Yes, he wasn't.
We'll just go beautiful. She's young for me, but beautiful woman.
Beautiful breasts.
Giving the distractions the Oilers needed to pull off to get to the Stanley Cup Finals. And we praise her.
She was beautiful. And I yes.
Yes.
Beautiful lady. She needs no name.
No. Because, you know, we're men. We won't remember it.
No. No, but it is important, so don't feel bad. It matters. Me too. Yeah,
she matters. She matters. She matters.
And, you know, clearly, those were 100% authentic
real breasts. Yes, no augmentations. They weren't bolt-ons.
Nope. So, that was a real deal.
Yeah, it was eye-opening for me, and I am starting to watch hockey more. She's a benefit. She's a benefit to the sport. And
she's like Caden Clark of hockey to me, and she doesn't even play.
Yeah. Which we're going to talk about her here in a bit.
Oh, boy. That's going to be okay. To save okay. The best for last kind of thing.
Here's the lowdown on this. Okay.
Are we going to be honest about it, or are we going to be YouTube censored?
We're going to be fully honest about it. I went through a lot of the news outlets on this, and finally, after all the news outlets and went in and kept on saying, it's like, it's this. We have the news, and we know what we're talking about. Here's the real news. This is just ridiculous how news companies have to like throw out a line and try to bait people. I'm going to go over their news and verify what it actually is. Caitlin Clark of Indiana Fever was not and is not going to be part of the Olympic top list of alternatives for the Olympic baseball team that's going to happen in Paris, France. Now, saying that, everybody's in an uproar about it. She's a great player. She's this. The fandom's going to outcry. We can't believe this is happening. And this is coming from Fox News, CBS News, CNN. And I'm naming all of them on both sides because that's what's happening. Here's the real stuff. She's not even disappointed. And she's understandable. She's like, hopefully one day I can get there. And the reasoning why they are not putting her on the team is she's new. She is fairly new. And they have a lot of veterans that are going to be on that team, which I understand that. Once you put it that way, and here's her on talking about it on X. I'm just going to do the sound on this. See if I can lower it a little bit. Because it's loud. It's blogging my ears. Okay, that way of press work or anything like that's her talking to this press and everything. Everybody else on every other news network is going out and it's like, she's too woke. She's not woke enough to be on the team. She's not this. She's not that. She's not this. What she was talking and the way she was talking, and I'll say it, and I'm going to hate myself a little bit for saying, but that's Michael Jordan level thinking. She wasn't upset. She's like, I got to improve. I have to be better. That's competitive. That's what that sport needs. And a lot of people are now watching the WNBA because of her, not because of any kind of drama that's happening. It's because they want to watch a player succeed. They want to watch somebody work a team in the highest level. And so every conversation she has through like PR stuff and everything, it's always the same thing. Well, we lost this. Well, I got to improve. It's nothing dramatic. It's nothing political. It's nothing. Hey, it's all on me. I'm going to work through this. I'm going to get through it. It's nobody's fault but mine. That's some competitor right there. And that's the way, you know, sports and people that are playing should act. That I was like, hey, all this showboat and drama shit they're doing, we need to stop and we need to go ahead. And I need to either A, we need to improve on how we play the field, or we need to find out which player needs a little bit more bump up on the levels and work with them. That's how sports is supposed to be. But none of this, you know, Max does a lot. A lot of other people on our podcast do it a lot. We'll make like political jokes and everything. But all around, when it comes down to it, we're talking sports on these episodes. That's what it is. That we're interested in the competition. We're not interested of their personal lives, although some of them are better entertainment. Like, what's that one Kansas City guy that just killed somebody in Dallas with a car? It was a hit and run incident. Rice?
Oh, Rasheed Rice?
Yeah. That's entertainment, but it's not, you know, sports entertainment. It should be.
You know, it puts a bad light on him. It puts a bad light on the organization. And, you know, it doesn't do much in way of making the NFL look better. You got individuals out here with felonies, domestic abuse charges, all kinds of issues. And it's not just the NFL necessarily, but
yeah, it's all sports and everything. And anybody that's being pushed into the spotlight, guaranteed that. But in all reality, what we want, what people want to see is our competitive players versus their competitive players. That's what they want. That's what everybody wants to watch. They want to see our team succeed over the other team. That's all of sports has always been. It's a lot better than what we used to do. We used to get up in lines and everything and cut each other up. But now we watch sports.
And just like in many other fraternities and organizations, whatever you want to call it, there's a good old boy, a buddy system, and everything. And that doesn't necessarily mean men. That includes women as well. And in this case, in my subjective opinion, yes, she does not fit the norm of the WNBA and the product that they currently have, though she has been the one to spearhead the WNBA rather into being relevant, into being entertaining. And not only that, she did the same thing while she was playing in college. By the way, she was the all-time leading collegiate scorer, men and women, not to mention the fact that she was the number one draft choice. That's just something we ought to throw out there. You already mentioned her competitive nature.
I don't put the draft, number one draft or anything up there, only because, yeah, they get like a cold bonus and everything. But in all reality, so many number one draft picks have been fails.
They have been. And in her case, I will say this. I don't see her being a failure because she doesn't, that's not her mindset. That's not her mentality. She's not built like that. You could tell right away just by her demeanor, the way she carries herself, that she's not your typical athlete. All right. She doesn't want fame. She wants success. She wants to be a winner. She wants to demonstrate how to win and influence others to do the same. In my opinion, she should never have gotten snubbed. And then, you know, aside from the fact that, yes, number one scorer in NCAA history. Yes, first all-round draft pick. Yes, most watched games since the WNBA has been around. But in my opinion, and this is subjective, and this is no one but mine, the reason she is not on that team is because of the good old boy or the good old girl system. She simply doesn't fit the narrative of what the WNBA currently has. And that is a combination of, you know, she's too straight. She's too white.
Well, that's what a lot of, I think that's a lot of people's opinion on that. They want to go for the easy and they don't want to go for the hard. Like, oh, she's this, she's that. She's not what we want to have our perspective of demographic watching. This is this type of sport. We don't want this, but she's winning. We don't care. And by the way, everybody who will eventually listen to this, because I know we actually have people that listen to this after we go off live, but we have our host being a jealous asshole.
He's in Galveston.
Boo, hiss, lame. What's up, boys?
Hey, Daddy.
Feel ignored. You should feel ignored. We're taking this show to the tops without you. He'll eventually get to that point. But he's sitting here with my beautiful wife at the harbor of Galveston, drinking tequila and staring at the USS Texas. Oh, it made it back from France. That's the nicest thing you ever said to me.
We miss you, Johnny.
Yeah, we somewhat miss you. Also, Johnny, so it made it back from France because they brought the USS Texas to the 80th anniversary of D-Day this weekend. No, it was last weekend. It was the sixth. Yep. It was last week. Yeah.
Remember all those posts and all those commemorative things?
Yeah, I was the one that sent everybody that stuff.
I think you were the only one in the entire social media platforms that did anything. They all forgot that this even happened.
Oh yeah. Yeah. He sent me the photo. God, I'm going to Galveston. I'm definitely going to Galveston sometime this summer. I'm going to go. I don't know if you can take a tour. Can you take a tour, Johnny? We'll wait on the stuff, but I think you can take a tour of the USS Texas. But that's the gangster of boats. I mean, you flood the bellows just so you can reach the enemy at a farther distance that the boat's supposed to be taken care of. Have you heard the story of USS Texas?
I have, but I think now is a fitting time to tell it.
I'm not going to tell it again. You can go into not right now. I think once they dock her at Seawolf Park. Okay. So, yeah. USS Texas, the shortest version I can probably do. USS Texas, prior to World War II, was manned by U.S. Marines. It is the popping out, guys. Have fun storming the castle. That was a Princess Bride reference. USS Texas was manned by Marines, not by the Navy at the time. They went in and they gained experience on the warship. And after the start, they were product to go to D-Day. They went to D-Day. They unloaded all of their weapons. Basically, they shot Honda Civics at an alarming rate at the front line. And then they had to reload. They reloaded. came back and the enemy forces were pushed back and USS Texas was not able to do it. And as good Texas fashion, like, hold my beer. They basically filled up. They started letting water in on one side of the ship, tilting it back so they're able to aim higher and shoot further. So they're able to shoot more Honda Civics. And that's the story of the USS Texas. That's the reason why it's so famous. But right now it's a museum. They're still trying to work on her.
She needs a little loving.
Yeah, she just needs a little loving. You can go to USSTexas.org, donate, so they can give her some love. I've been wanting to go to that ship for a long time. I'm now able to do it. It's just I'm waiting on a lot of stuff to go through. But basically, you can buy pieces of the steel, so basically pieces of the ship. They have like Texas state emblems of the ship through the steel, you know, a bunch of other stuff. And it all goes to fixing her up and for the donations and everything. I was surprised that she actually made it to France. Or not France, Normandy. France is in Normandy. Damn it. I'm being an idiot right now.
Utah, Omaha, Gold, Juno, Sword.
Like Matt, the Mad Piper of Normandy.
The maddest.
You know why he was called the Mad Piper of Normandy, right?
We're gonna about to find out.
Because he was playing bagpipes.
Bagpipes. True story.
Yeah, there. What's funny is the Lord that was his commander. The Piper was like, "Should we be doing this?" I was like, "Well, those are English laws. We're Scottish. We have a different breed." And I'm like, "Yeah, but that makes me proud." But anyways. Going back to talking sports, we went a little bit off on that one, which we usually do. So, no big deal on that. Next thing that we were supposed to talk about, what was it? I put up a thing on our thumbnail where we were supposed to talk about. Let me look and find out. Oh, yeah, cricket. We were actually talking about cricket. I forgot because who in the United States talks about cricket? Not that many people. And the reason why we are talking about cricket is if you're looking in the betting world, we're like negative 2,500, negative 2,500 to win, get any kind of spot in the world cricket team. That's how horrible people think of United States and cricket because we don't play cricket that much. Even though we've been part of the association since 1965. That's the reason why we weren't up there for the last, but what happened, and I'll give you a little bit of a pre-story on this. 2 years ago, they actually decided to go in and do like the 1988 Olympic hockey team. They wanted to have it was sometime in the 80s. It was like 1980.
Are you talking about the Miracle on Ice?
Yes. Yes.
80. That was what? 84 or 82. I'm sorry. 82.
Yeah. Basically, Russia at the time was the biggest hockey team. Nobody could beat them. But United States be United States, we always say, hold my beer. And we go out and beat the crap out of things. And that's the whole reason why Max is over here. He immigrated from Russia because it's like, if they can do that with hockey, they're probably improved on everything else. So let's go ahead and go over there. That's my thinking. Is that how it happened, Max?
Yes, that is actually exactly how it happened.
There we go. See?
No, you know, when did we get here? Hold on. We got here in 81. So, so I was still before it was Russian, I was still Soviet.
Yeah.
Couldn't help it. But yeah, that team, it wasn't composed of just athletes. It was composed of, super athletes, KGB agents, just the ultimate team that you could ever think of that was unbeatable. And the United States had a bunch of young guys, a bunch of no names, and there they were, the biggest moment of their lives on the biggest stage, and they beat the Soviets. And then we left, never to return again.
Yeah.
Thank God.
But we're talking about cricket because the U.S. cricket team beat the number six team in the world, Pakistan, in cricket this weekend. And they're about to go to the number one team. The number one team is India. And from what I understand, reading the stuff on the U.S. Cricket team is there's two other players who we're going up against. The first one, the next one that we're going up against is going to be India. India, we don't have to win to advance. But Ireland, when we play up against Ireland, we have to win that one to actually go further into the tournament, which is that one part just got confused. It's like we don't have to beat the number one team, but we have to beat the number two seat. Because Ireland, what's the standing on Ireland?
Those Irish, you just got to outsmart them. You got to outthink them. What you got to do is you have to have a lot of potatoes on your side. And the Irish, they're going to see these potatoes. They're like, oh, fuck, they got potatoes. I'm so fucking hungry right now. I'd do anything for that potato. Oh, those potatoes look delicious. What are those, Idaho russets? Oh, shit, those look like little red potatoes, aren't they? We have all these different potatoes. The Irish people love potatoes. It's not stereotyping. It's true. So yeah, I figure if we have these potatoes, bags of potatoes, on the sidelines, we can distract the Irish and win this game. Now, the Indians, we're going to have to do a little something different. Distract them, we're going to have to put, like, computers and shit. Maybe some curry. But definitely a different strategy.
Let me... standing.
It's all mental warfare at this point.
Let's see here. Standing. I don't know. 2004 standing. Okay, this is the team status right now. There's an A and B team. This is how much we know. There's okay. Here are the group stage. God, this is not American sport. This is a total different sport. The A team is
the A team.
Yeah, A team: India, U.S., Canada, Pakistan, and Israel. The B team is Scotland, Australia, NAM, England, and OMA. They got a C team, they got a D team, and that's it. I don't know. I have to do, I did like enough research to get us by for what talking about the USA stuff. What is that noise, Max?
That noise is me finishing up. Nothing.
Sweet baby Jesus. Now, like I said, we have to, United States has to beat Ireland just to go up. And I can't find the standings of Ireland. But I ended up learning a little bit how the game is played. Find out by yourself, because I'm not explaining that. It's their home run is 6 points. I was wondering why the score was so high. If you hit the cricket ball, that's the only way I can describe it. If you hit the cricket ball and it goes into the infield and they toss around and they try to get you out, the way that you get points is you run back and forth, both of your bat, because there's two batters, both batters like switch, and you switch as many times as you possibly can to get as many points. But if you hit a home run, it's automatic six. And if you hit it, there's no foul area or anything like that. And basically the way that they get you out is they hit three posts. And if the bags on the posts fall off, you're out. That's cricket. That's the super simplest way I can actually say it is. That's cricket. And they're welling.
Are you surprised that we suck at cricket?
I'm surprised we even freaking do it. I don't know. It's a combination of baseball and running the bases. It's stupid simple, honestly. It's a stupid simple game if you learn how to do it. Because the only okay.
If we haven't got it done since the 60s, I don't know if it's maybe it's just not meant to be.
No, it's okay. Here's a little light on cricket. How us Americans are ignorant on this sport compared to other countries. What is the most popular player in the world?
Like currently?
Yeah, currently.
Of all sports or just cricket?
No, just sports in general. What do you think is the most popular player? A lot of people would play right now.
Right now. If I were to say the most popular player right now, it still probably have to be Michael Jordan.
Okay. That's old retirement. Let's go with like now. A lot of people will just say LeBron James is probably the most popular. He probably has the most people on Instagram and everything. You know, most followers. We'll go with that way. Most followers. Okay.
All right.
We'll go Instagram real quick. And because it'll automatically come up on there. Okay. Hopefully
this son of a bitch doesn't fall off again.
Okay, LeBron. Yeah, it is annoying. LeBron James on Instagram had 1.3 followers. Okay. That's impressive. But that's kind of impressive, right? You know, having 1.3 million followers. That's just bad baseball. But, you know, the person that's most in sports and everything, we'll even go to Michael Jordan. We'll go Michael Jordan on this. Luckily AI, because I'm horrible, but let's see here. Nope, that's not him. I don't know if he has an Instagram.
That's a good question. I wonder if 2311 Racing has an Instagram.
Hmm. I'm not seeing it. All of them are fake ones or anything.
Right. Like, I don't even think.
He'd probably be up there. You know, let's.
Are you going to the old school Google search?
Yeah. Most popular. Okay, the most popular player is Virat Kohli. Okay. On Instagram, as of May 2024, Kohli has 268.31 million followers on Instagram. That's a quarter of a billion people keep up with him.
I think he might be monetized.
That's how much the world views cricket. That's how popular cricket is. Cricket outside of the United States is super popular. That and soccer or football. Those are the most popular sports in the world. The reason why we're having games in other countries. I mean, every team's gone to a different country. I think the big conversation right now, I mean, even in NFL news right now, we'll go back. You know, we'll pop back and forth on news. In NFL news right now, there's a big controversy about the teams that are going to a different country for the NFL season. You know what the controversy is? This is so weird. I get weird sports news. The controversy is they're going to Brazil to play for the NFL because they're trying to broaden their audience through different countries. The controversy is they can't wear green on the field because of the place that it's at.
It was the Packers and the Jets, or
yes,
was that what? Yeah,
they can't wear green. The Packers, what are their colors again? I'm kind of confused. I don't think it's green, is it? It's not green.
Still, yellow, right? Still green and yellow.
Are you sure?
I'm gonna Google this, but I'm gonna go yes.
I'm not. You know me. I'm talking sports on this show today. And I have no idea.
Green and yellow
stuff. Are you sure? Did you Google that? Go ahead and Google it again. Make sure it's green and yellow.
I promise you, it's green and yellow as it gets.
Okay.
And then the Jets are more of a green and white type theme. So they both have green as their primary color.
They can't even. They get fined for wearing green at the stadium. There was a soccer team. One of the soccer teams is one of their main colors is green. One of the soccer players wore green shoes, cleats, and they got fined for like I think it's equivalent of $5,000. Yeah, yeah.
What is it with green that is so?
Oh. Man, I give you part of the story and you're supposed to help out.
I know a portion of it, but I can't say for the life of me what it is about green in particular.
It's one of the other teams.
And then I guess the other question is, the NFL being the mental giants that they are, couldn't have figured this out prior to making the schedule and putting this particular game with these two particular teams that have green is their primary colors in a place that doesn't allow green.
Okay, here it is. On, we'll wait for the freaking commercial.
It's always
very we'll just listen to this. Here's the full story. Yeah. Okay. So it's a gang problem. And yes, where they're going, do they tell you? Okay. They inform you when you go to like places like Brazil, Rio de Janeiro, and stuff like that. They don't tell you. It's like, hey, be on the lookout for people that are trying to rob you. They tell you, hey, you're going to get robbed when you walk around, so be careful. I mean, Brad Williams, the midget comedian, he talked about it on one of his specials. He's like, he did it funnier than I'm gonna do, but he literally said, it's like, I had to have an extra wallet and an extra phone so I could give that to the robbers so I could keep my stuff and I wasn't gonna get stabbed or killed. Of course, he took the liberty of taking the extra phone and making a lot of dick pics. So that was the thing.
Dick pics.
Yeah. So last and least, let me go into my messages in here because Johnny gave me a laundry list of little bit of stuff to talk about because let's see here, because Carl Larson won yesterday's race. I almost said match.
Sonoma home court.
Now, because the other thing, man, I just don't pay attention to a lot of stuff. Kyle Larson's the one that went to Indy 500 too, right?
Yep, he's the one that went.
Okay,
attempted the double.
Okay, he attempted the double. He won at Sedona. Now, they actually gave him a pass, so he's able to get those points, but the way Johnny explains it is he was able to get those points for the playoffs. So he's still able to go to the playoffs unless he like something really bad happens. Can you emphasize on that? Because I have no idea with NASCAR. I don't keep up. There's no news, big news on that one for me.
From my understanding, the NASCAR Association was accommodating to Kyle Larson in way of the waiver for the effort made in trying to run the double, but whether being out of his control, one of the elements obviously none of us can control, he was given the waiver and, you know, no harm, no foul type scenario. And then this past weekend at Sonoma, he was able to run. He ran first, ended up finishing first, got the points, still. It's as though the double, even though it happened, it never really happened, and it didn't happen in a way that affected him negatively. And people out there that were saying things prior to when the NASCAR announcement came that the waiver would be granted for him and the accommodation was going to be made, though he did not race, he was still present. The only one that I could really recall that had an issue with it was Bubba Wallace. And there were other people that, you know, might not have liked it, but Bubba Wallace was more vocal than others about it. And I think I mentioned on the show last week when that initially happened and he ran the double before the waiver was given and the accommodation was given, that, you know, being on 2311's race team and having Jordan as an owner of that car slash race team, in addition with Mr. Hamlin, that you would think that the guy behind the wheel would have that same type of mentality, that same type of drive, no pun intended, as the owner of the vehicle, i.e. the greatest basketball player in history, Michael Jordan. But I don't see that in Bubba Wallace. Kyle Larson, I think he's on a whole nother level. He brings people in to want to watch the sport more. He's brought in a whole nother audience. He's exciting to watch. And I think it would be a big mistake, kind of like with the Olympic Committee for the ladies basketball national team, didn't make the mistake that NASCAR made and decided to go ahead and keep the ratings, keep the people happy, versus doing something to ruffle feathers and piss people off. So my hat's off to NASCAR. My hat's off to Mr. Larson and all the other racers yesterday. Everybody did a great job and nobody got hurt. So,
yeah, that's the general idea with these, with the sports going to different. I mean, even WWE is going to different countries to wrestle over there. I mean, they do the pay-per-view. There was one, like one in Backlash was in England. King of the Ring was in, Backlash was in France. Another one was in, I think the latest one, the King and Queen of the Ring, was in Saudi Arabia, I believe.
It was.
But they're branching out. I mean, if you want to make like a lot of money on these events and on the sports in general, I mean, yes, all these sports make billions of dollars. But here's the thing. We're only making billions. I mean, if I was running a company, like right now we're running with t-shirts. If I wanted to sell like our t-shirts in one country, said it's like you can't use the word the. We'll just say that. You can't use the word the. Our country doesn't like that word. And I had a t-shirt that had the word the in it. And if I could work around it to say the, instead of going off in the whole, this is America, we have the First Amendment. A lot of countries don't have the First Amendment. A lot of countries jail people for saying their mind. England. It's sad that I have to say England and not any of the communist countries.
Yeah, Russia, though not communist by name, is still pretty much a communist country, and they'll put you to jail, to prison, to a gulag, kill you, assassinate you, poison you.
Yeah,
doesn't matter.
I guess that's the reason why they don't jail a lot of people for what they say. They just kill them. Anyways, back off of that. But if you want more profit and you want a broader audience for your company, you sell the products geared to that country. Yeah. What is it? I think McDonald's does it a little bit. The Royale with cheese. I mean, it's the whole thing from Pulp Fiction. It's not quarter pound with cheese. It's Royale with cheese.
You could have one giant company, whether it's, you know, McDonald's or some other conglomerate. They're going to market differently based on their demographics. So,
yeah, exactly. I mean, right now we have, you know, Pride Month, and a lot of companies, it's so hilarious that a lot of companies in like places around here, if you see, it's like BMW of United States or Audi, United States, and they had the Pride flag. They changed their Pride stuff to Pride stuff and everything for the month. But if you could go and see, it's like Toyota or BMW of Saudi Arabia, it's just a regular symbol. Wonder why that is. They don't like toss people out of buildings or anything for being a certain like demographic or anything, right?
No, it's illegal to be homosexual in certain countries.
No, are you sure?
Yeah, 100%.
The whole world is. We're not, you know, a freedom-based country to where that doesn't happen anywhere else.
Yeah. What if I told you that there's countries like China, which is, you know, a communist country, they got a constitution. Yeah. Vietnam, they've got a constitution. They're communists. North Korea, they've got a constitution. Also communist. Cuba, constitution. Communist. So,
yeah.
Yeah, there's...
Yeah, it's one of those things that, you know, you go with whatever country you're going to, like the whole thing with the Green Bay Packers and Eagles. Honestly, I know what happened. What happened is the NFL signed the documents and put everything up without researching the place that they were going to. That was the problem. And that's always the problem. People jump the gun. I jump the gun a lot of the times. I mean, Max is the only one that doesn't say anything, but Johnny and Chris like put a foot up my ass every time I say something stupid. So this is non-bullying episode of Nerd Sports, which is kind of funny.
No bullying from me.
Yeah. But it's really funny they didn't do the research beforehand so they can like make the teams understand, because they're like I said from the video is they're not even leaving their hotel room. I mean, I'm wondering how they're going to do the practice and everything. They have to have armored vehicles. It's one of those things is. You could have done a little
bit
of research.
Nobody really thought this one through.
No one thought this then through. No one at all. But anyways, that's all the sports news. We did an hour and 20 minutes for sports news, so that's good. The big thing for the nerd side of this thing, Johnny mentioned that the 30th anniversary. Can't be the 30th. It has to be. It's the anniversary of Close Encounters of the Third Kind when they're going back in the theaters. And there was some other movie that was doing the same thing. So
30 years.
It's not 30 years. It's more than that. It came out in the 80s. It has to be like 40. Because I'm 45. And that movie came out. Like early 80s.
Yeah.
It came out in 77. So it's 40.
Yeah.
That's 46 years.
It's 47 years old.
Yeah. But they're doing you can watch it July the 7th. July the 7th in Wichita Falls. They're having two showies, one at 3 p.m. and one at 7 p.m. It's going to be back into theaters. And it is, I wonder how much of the box office off of this was $306 million. I'm kind of curious what the budget was.
$306 million.
Third Kind. Okay. Wikipedia. There we go. Okay. 19.4 million. It made 306, 306.9 million. Wow. Now, granted, back then, 19 million. I'm really curious of inflation, how much this actually is nowadays. See how much it would make nowadays. Let's put this here. Or today it would be okay, inflation calculator. God. Value of $13 million. Okay, it would have been made for $67 million, and I'll just go $300 million. And it would have been, it would have made like what it usually makes around here is $1.25 billion. Is that?
Yeah, if it would have been 19.6 back in 77, and now it's 67 million, so we're just round up, so 20 and go 70, it's almost tripled. I mean, yeah, 2.5 times.
Yeah.
That's unbelievable. That's totally unbelievable.
It really is. It really is unbelievable. If you look at the time frame on both those films and everything, I mean, everybody nowadays is like, oh, the Avengers made $1 billion. And if you look at it, if it was made like back in the 70s, it would probably be like $300 million.
Yeah.
That's inflation of ticket prices and everything.
I don't know how many people go to the movie theaters like they used to. I don't think it's
pre. I know definitely on certain movies I'll go to the theater, like Dune 2, Part 2. I went to go see the theaters because I knew it was one of those visually minded movies. Right after this or tomorrow, I'm gonna go see Bad Boys 4. I mean, I want to watch that. And then I think I know definitely July I'm going to theaters for Deadpool and Wolverine. I'm definitely gonna go see that.
Yeah, so, the trailer looked awesome.
Yeah, it does. I mean, the Venom 3 is coming out too. Venom 3 is coming out, and they just dropped the trailer for that. That looks pretty good. But there's some movies out there that I kind of wish I got to watch it on. I got to go to a theater to go see it.
Yeah. I think I've been to the theater maybe once or twice since 2020, and they've been like, I don't know, empty, just
yeah,
sad. Yeah, I places.
Went to go see like Dune Part 2, and mind you, I pick and choose the days I go. I mean, they're pretty ish packed. They weren't like super packed, because it was like a Friday or Saturday night. They're pretty packed, but on the other days they're not. It really was just me. And they're assigned, what's funny is they're assigned seats now in most theaters. So you go in and you get to pick your seat, and you get to sit in the middle. And so you have the whole screen towards you, and I'm judgmental. I failed in geometry, but I know how to sit in a theater by using geometry, if you know what I'm saying.
Right,
it's kind of weird, but it really is one of those things that it's an experience. It's like watching. I wish we had. That's another thing that upsets me about the place I live. Like 45 minutes towards Dallas or towards Oklahoma. And I can go watch something in IMAX. And Lawton is the same size of Wichita Falls, and we don't have an IMAX theater.
Man.
Yeah.
You know, I know a lot of theaters out here. We had a bunch of them, but shit, so many of them took a hit after things all shut down. Yeah.
I mean,
but I guess if there wasn't one to begin with, then probably putting one up isn't priority for them. But yeah, the film industry right now, the only movie I'm looking forward to see other than the ones that you'd mentioned is Furiosa.
I'm really not into watching that one for some reason.
Really? I'm not a Mad Max guy.
I love Mad Max. I don't want to go see it in theaters. I kind of, I should go. It's just one of those storylines that they're just pandering to him for the crowd. Honestly, I was like, let's have a female lead on this one.
I know.
Make it gay and what was it? There's a South Park thing. It's like make it gay and something else. I can't remember. Hold on.
Yeah, I know what came out Memorial Day weekend. So far, it's been less than. It hasn't performed as well as people would have hoped, like those that made it. So they're talking about going to Max for streaming here within the next month. And conveniently enough, the prices of Max, if you currently don't have it, then you're not aware. But those of us that do have Max, it has gone up and the price increase is also effective next month also.
What's really strange is the Prime. I've been watching like a Prime original series, blah, blah, blah. They've been putting commercials in those things. I fucking hate commercials. If I'm paying something per month just to watch that specific website, I'm paying it not to watch commercials. Netflix, right. Don't want to watch commercials.
Nope.
I mean, I got YouTube. I mean, this right here, this account doesn't have it, but I got YouTube Prime. I don't watch commercials
at all. Nope.
I mean, I had this theory. It's like, if you're rich enough, you don't know what's going on in the world because you pay as much money as you possibly can, so you don't see commercials.
Yeah, I don't want to see commercials because I see the same commercials every fucking time. The only time I see commercials is, and I try to avoid them also, is like, you know, they watch, you know, NBA Finals, Stanley Cup Finals, Super Bowl, obviously, they fucking flood you with it. But otherwise, if it's something that I want to watch, not a single commercial. I don't have to see any dick growth pills or anything else. So, yeah.
Yeah, you get it on TikTok all the time, though. Everybody,
I don't have a TikTok just because of China. Fuck them.
That's pretty much all the news for sports and nerd stuff. Other than I kind of don't want to say it only because it's I got rid of Disney Plus and I found out that they're starting to sell like DVDs or the seasons where you don't have to buy. Like, I'll support like certain shows if I see like clips for them and everything. But other than that, I don't get like the big subscriptions anymore. Because Netflix, you have like a good show or movie come out on Netflix maybe once or twice a month now. I mean, I just bought, big on Peacock, The Continental, and I paid like $19. I paid for a month just to watch something that I wanted to watch. And I didn't have to spend, if I wanted to, I could have rented it for cheaper.
Yeah, it's a fucking racket. All of it's a racket.
Well, it's business. I understand that. We're trying to make a business once we get popular enough. But it's just one of those things. It's like, I understand in a business practice and everything, but you're not going to... Right now, people aren't able to spend that much money. They can either A, spend a lot of money to be entertained, or B, eat, have shelter. And a lot of people are choosing the eating and shelter, and they're going for the cheap stuff for entertainment and everything, which is TikTok's cheap and easy. YouTube, it's cheap and easy. I mean, you get commercials and everything. Not a lot of there's some people that are buying cable, but I had this thing when I first like realized it. It was just like a snap of a finger. I made it cheaper on me. People were like, oh, yeah, I'm going to come over to Dave's place and we're going to watch the game. I'm like, I had a big screen TV, but I didn't have like cable. They're like, why don't you have cable? I was like, because all the stuff I want to watch is online. I don't have to.
Right.
All I have to do is pay an enormous amount for internet, and I can watch anything I want. I was like, well, we want to watch the game. I'm like, well, I can't help you there. Oh, sorry. Then eventually someone gave me their like cable account, so I could actually, you know, all I had to do was like do the internet through the cable company and get it online, and we can watch TV through that way. But it, I mean, I figured this out like in 2007, 2006, I believe. And I stopped, you know, getting cable. It was like $50 for stuff that I, and then the reason why I did it is because I didn't have to watch commercials.
Yeah.
To watch anything. I just hooked up. I was like, if I hook up my computer up to the TV, I'll have a big screen TV and I can watch anything on the internet. And now everything's just through your TV anyways. So that's beneficial.
Everything is a computer.
So we'll go ahead. We did an hour and 30 minutes, and that's usually our marker for this. And at the end of about an hour sideline, we get into the nerd stuff. But we did all that, and thank you all for listening. Thank you all for watching. Hopefully pretty soon I'm gonna jot some stuff down. I took this week off so I could do that. I'm gonna get with Johnny and hopefully Max and see what we can do as a show. Maybe make some improvements and everything. So, stuff that I've seen, maybe stuff that he sees that we do. The only thing I surprised myself this weekend when I was doing Psychos and Sociopaths, is I had to change. I changed my voice. It's like when I was doing that reading, I changed my voice just a tad, and I could go over the whole read without having to worry about anything. So I guess I have like a radio voice now. I found my radio voice, so I can actually talk, and my brain realizes what I'm seeing and what I'm supposed to be saying, and I go through it like flawlessly. It's really strange. I have to literally. It's slowing down my voice to a point. It's so weird. Let me read something on here. Let me see if I can do this. $300 million in 1977 is equivalent to the purchasing power about $1.5 million today, an increase of $1.25 million over 47 years. The dollar had an average inflation of 3.56 per year between 1977 to today, producing a commodity price increase in 417.41%. I just slowed it down a little bit. That's all I did. I slowed it down, lowered my voice just a tad, and now I can enunciate and get all the information out there as much as possible. It's really strange. If I talk like this, I'm perfect. I get everything done right and adequate. But if I just do my regular voice, I can't do it. I literally have a radio voice now.
I think you sound good either way. I don't mean that in a funny way. If you know me.
All right. If you want to see my penis, you want to see my penis. Anyways.
See a man's penis.
Anyways, I'm David Dickerman.
I'm Mad Max.
This is Nerd Sports 164. Thank you all for listening. Thank you for always listening, watching us. Make sure you share this with other people. I don't think we're popular enough to be shadow banned, but I might. I don't know if we are or not. I think it's just, you know, we're so small fries. Nobody's looking for us anyways. Every once in a while, we get weird stuff happening to us. But you have to share, you have to like, you have to comment on our stuff to get us popping. That's even us. If we actually like our own stuff to the point that what did you say it was like five people? We got to get five likes. I give us two. Give us two because I have my own account and I have the Angry Me production account. So I give us two free ones every time. That's really weird saying that I have to do that. But we were never popular. We didn't do streams and got popular. We never did, you know, become political standings to where we talk political stuff and we became popular. We are just guys, literally. And I hate to say this, we're all losers in the eyes of social media. And we don't promote ourselves that well. So if you would please promote us, if you made it this long into the episode. Now, I probably need to do it in the beginning of the podcast. If you promote us and you like us a little bit, and most of the time I talk to people, they actually like us. They more or less like the criminal side, the psychos and sociopaths. But, you know, give us a like. Share us with people. Let us blossom. And I literally have people that are fans of the show come on the show. I love the interaction with the other people and everything. It's so great, so wonderful that I get to talk to people that is sometimes a little bit out there and crazy, but at least they get somebody to hear them out and conversate with them, and it's fun for everybody that's on here. I mean, we have Max here that's part of the show now constantly, and we only did like one episode, and I was like, hey, listen, one day we might need somebody extra to come on the show and we have a good conversation with, and Max is a loser and he doesn't do anything else with his life, so we might as well take him in like a lost puppy. I mean, it worked
out. I'll be your Huckleberry.
You know what's Huckleberry? You know what's Huckleberry? The actual phrase is Huckleberry. No, a Huckleberry.
Just like Flavor Raven who Kool-Aid.
No. And I know we're going to end this stream. But a Huckleberry. Let's end the stream.
No, we got to do Huckleberry.
No, I'm can't. I'm,